The following video is sponsored by the Greek American Heritage Society of Philadelphia.
The story of America is the story of the immigrant. And today, here inside the Greek American community of Philadelphia, that celebration is taking place. A celebration of cousins and a celebration that is called the centennial, a 100-year celebration of the Seiss family in America.
My name is Harry Seiss, just as you see on my tag as well. I'm going to be 83 years old in another couple months, and I am living here in Upper Darby for the last 50 years. In my younger days, I was a jeweler, a watchmaker, and I was in business for a number of years until I retired. And since then, I've been doing a lot of traveling, and I take an interest in history and in, as well as I have my hobbies and things like that to keep me busy. First of all, with my name, the last name is not a Greek name, but it's actually a Turkish word that comes from the Arabic language, which is the name Seiss. Means the same thing in Greek as Hippocomedes. And of course, if you take the name or the word hippo and put komos, it becomes Hippocomedes. And my people, my parents, both of them were from Pontos in what is now northeastern Turkey on the Black Sea coast. And my father came to America in 1913 as a young man of 18 and a half years old. And he never went back to his homeland in Turkey. And he settled and raised his family here in America. And I had two other brothers and a sister. And of course, my father has passed away, and one of my brothers has passed away. And I live with my sister in Upper Darby, Pennsylvania. Neither of us has ever married. And I devote many of my hours on this project of family history and other hobbies as well. I'm also very much involved in history of Europe and Asia Minor and other subjects like it. I feel as much Greek as I am an American as well. The cousins that are here today, they've started doing this sort of thing sort of individually in smaller groups some years ago, maybe 20 or 25 years ago. However, in the past about 10 years, the group has expanded and more cousins have come together. And from time to time, a new one is found, just like today. We have introduced new cousins that we recently discovered were among us, living over in New Jersey. And they turned out to be, to me, second cousins. That is, they were my grandfather's brother's grandchildren. So it's quite interesting to learn about these people. And they, too, are interested in learning about themselves. So it's been a wonderful experience learning about their little bit of their ancestry, part of it anyway. The dressy apron that the ladies in the Black Sea region, all along the Black Sea, the women of the house, and a lot of the older women especially, still wear these aprons when they go out to market and so on. Sometimes when they go to festive occasions, they have special ones that are maybe a little fancier or made out of silk material, whereas most of them are just cotton, and they just wrap it around their waist in the back, and that's their little apron. And I must tell you that these aprons are usually representative of a different area where they come from by the stripes and the combination of stripes. Those copper pots, they were brought from Constantinople by my father's sisters when they came to America in 1921. Since they landed in New York Harbor at Ellis Island in January the 2nd of 1921.
And there's a small glass.
Yeah, those copper pots, they were used for many years until finally my aunt decided she's going to get modern pots, but they were very well made. The little jar there, that holds some soil from the village of Chal in Pontos, up in the mountains, where I visited with my brother and sister and my cousin about 20 years ago. We took a trip and visited that whole region, and we spent some time up in Chal to take pictures, video, and things like that. And we picked up some soil to bring back. And through the years, in the recent years, from time to time when we have a Pontian funeral of people that we know, close relatives, I always give some of this soil to the priest when he's ready to sprinkle the soil on the coffin or in the coffin.